Girl, of course we talk about our hair.
And we talk over each other, because that's what girls do.
That is what girls do, especially when you're with Jackie Blair.
Yes. We got a star for y'all. I mean, clearly, come on. Yeah. Come on.
Oh, my goodness. Y'all are beautiful, and I'm just, and you're all tall. I can definitely safely say that I'm short, and I.
Hey, good thing I didn't wear heels today. Normally, I'm the short one.
Nothing wrong with that this morning. We are so happy to have you here. Jackie Velasquez is here with us this morning.
Thank you, guys.
Hey. You are a legend. And guys, if you have listened to any of her albums, any of her songs, please comment below. If you're a fan, comment below.
Yeah, tell us what your favorite song, too.
Yes, tell us what your favorite song is, where you're watching from, and all that good stuff. So we are so
excited. We want to hear your voice.
Yes, exactly.
We do.
But yeah, we have some questions for you from our followers. But first, tell us why you're here this morning.
Well, I have a new record that came out in March, and it's exciting. I have some movies coming out, and the record is called Trust, and it's a double disc, Confío and Trust. Mm-hmm. So, like, if you go to the store and you buy the, you know, the physical record, I thought this was kind of a really cool ministry tool, is if you speak English and you don't speak Spanish, but you know somebody who may need a little inspiration in their lives, but they speak Spanish, you can give that to them.
That's
so it's
cool.
Like two for one and a way to minister to others.
Definitely.
So yeah,
That's great.
Yes, and it's the same record, English and Spanish, but it's a it's a worship record with, you know, bits of other songs as well, but primarily it's about, you know, adoring and worshiping and as one, as his kids, just coming for him and honoring him and blessing him.
That's good. Yeah. That's good. Yeah. Now, how, like, what came from this album? What inspired you to do this album?
Well, you know, it's interesting you asked that, because I was raised in a Christian home, so worshiping God is just something we've always done. You know, at church, you know, you worship, and but I didn't know much about the genre of worship, like the music genre of worship. Yeah. And so I'd never made one of those records, so I didn't really understand why Integrity wanted me to do that. I was like, I don't really know much about it. So, of course, God spoke to me the only way that I would hear him, and that was through my 7-year-old son. They had sent me a batch of songs, and I listened through them, and this one song stuck out to me. Later that night, my son called me in the middle of the night, 2 a.m., said, "Mom, Mom!" And I said, "What's up, bud?" He goes, "I had 2 bedrooms. I said, "Well, what were they?" He goes, "One was, there were 2 cars speeding really fast and they hit each other." And I said, "Oh, bud, I'm sorry, but that didn't happen, don't worry." Mm-hmm. He said his 2nd bedroom was that Satan was trying to take over the world.
Wow.
And I said, "Well, let me tell you a secret. Satan really is trying to take over the world. So, but you don't have to worry. Do you love Jesus?" He says, "Yes." I said, "Well, then you never have to fear, because you know the God who moves mountains." And I remembered that song that I'd heard earlier in the day, and I brought the phone over to him and I played that song for him. And in the middle of the song, I just closed my eyes and raised my hands. And when I opened my eyes, I looked at my little boy, and he had tears coming down his face.
Wow.
And you could feel the presence of God in such a massive, huge way that there was no fear. I asked him, "Are you okay?" He goes, "Yes." Because you could just feel the sweetness of God. So that's when that happened, I was like, "Okay, God, let's rock and roll. I'm with you. I'm with you."
And now there's a CD to prove it. That's so
awesome.
Really. Can you tell us about the movie that you're in?
Oh, it's called A Question of Faith.
Okay.
And it is coming out September 29th, I believe. And it is it's 3 different stories that all kind of intertwine. And I mean, the title of it really says it all. It's, you know, we say we believe, but what does it take for us to get there to believe? It's very easy to be a watered down believer. So sometimes God pushes you to that extreme to really just go put your face on the floor and just go, "God, come on."
Yeah, that's good. What when does it come out again?
September 29th.
September 29th, guys. What is it called again?
A Question of Faith.
A Question of Faith. Come on. You guys need to see it.
Yep.
But we do have some shout-outs from our followers.
Oh, come
on.
We're
huge fans. We posted a promo. Okay, so this is on Instagram. This is Melicia. She says, "I remember being a teen and getting so excited, one of Jackie's new CDs, the smell of the freshly printed CD, reading the lyrics for the first time, heart emoji, CD emoji." How cute is that? that. And then everyone's like, love her, hearts. Yeah. And then we got some people on Facebook who also were saying some really awesome things. This is Tiffany. Love her. She's amazing. Thank you so much for hosting her wonderful album. This is Blossom. She's one of my, among my best artists and my favorite artist. She's from Nigeria.
Thank you, Blossom.
Right? We just have a lot of people just saying that they're just huge fans. So.
Yeah. And we did have a question that came in from Trey. It says, what does it feel like to have been in the music industry for so long?
Oh, well, it feels like a long time. No, it feels good. It feels good to know that people, that something that you're doing, your art, your ministry is resonating and touching hearts. Because, I mean, why do something if you're if it's not working? It's like, God, take me where you want stuff to work, where I can be useful. And I think that probably the biggest misconception is that people feel like you have to be on stage or be making music or all that to be in ministry, and that's just not the case. You minister right where you are,
that's right.
And He uses us in all different ways.
That's right.
It's not big, it's not little, it's just God using you.
Yeah, that's right. Another question, this is from Angie. She said, I found out that one of your sons is autistic. What word of encouragement could you give to other mothers out there raising children with autism?
My oldest son is autistic. He is 9 years old, and he's awesome. He is the coolest kid in the world. Yeah. I mean, he really is amazing.
That's cool.
You know, I guess the best advice, because I had never had a child. So my first child that was born, so I'm learning how to be a mom, and then learning how to be a special needs mom. That was kind of a lot. What I learned through the process and what I'm still learning is you gotta be willing to fight. You have to fight. It doesn't feel good. Sometimes you're not the most liked person. That means you have to be willing to research. Learn every opportunity. Learn what therapies would be helpful, what your insurance covers, what therapies your school offers. And if they don't offer the therapy that you believe will work for your child, then you fight for it. You go in there and make sure that your child has every opportunity for success, because God entrusted you with that baby.
That's right. That is good. Thank you so much for that. It's amazing.
Thank you. She will be on the 700 Club.
The 7
in just a few minutes. Velasquez.
We're dancing today.
And you're singing this morning, right?
Yes, yes.
She is singing.
Awesome.
So we will post a link. Make sure you watch.
Yes. 700 Club exclusive, y'all. Just for you.
You heard from her first.
Yep. Well, thank you so much, Jackie.
Thank you, guys.
All right, guys. Thanks for watching. God bless you. Cool.
Awesome.
There we go. That was good.
Awesome.